joy or happiness, success or failure, peace or dismay. The foundations of our life rest on the words we receive. A word of hope and guidance, translated from the Temple of Solomon in Brazil. You're listening to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
Univere Video is your platform for Christian content, and it gives you access to the church meetings of the Universal Church around the world, and they are in English. Even the meetings at the Temple of Solomon that provide live, simultaneous translations to English. All you have to do is sign up, and this is how. Visit www.univerevideo.com online or download the application on your mobile device and complete the simple registration form. Have your bank card ready and choose your terms of payment. And before you know it, you'll be up and running. Stay connected to the things of faith during the 21 days fast of Daniel.
Hello, my friends. A very good morning, good dawn. And may God bless all of you, giving you understanding of His holy word, so that through His word you may take possession of what it says and promises. That's what God wants to do. He wants you and I, each of us, to have or to take possession of what is written and determined. And each person has to do their part. And speaking of which, I would like to share with you this magnificent text, this biblical text that speaks about Goliath and David, the confront between Goliath and David, which is the confront that each of us have in our lives. I had many Goliaths before me, many Goliaths. And thank God, by the name of the Lord, by the word of the Lord, by the Spirit of the Lord, I have been defeating them. Thank God. And we want you to also defeat your Goliaths. But in order for you to defeat your Goliaths, you have to apply your faith exclusively in the Word of God, which is the promise of God. Pay attention. When David went to confront Goliath, Goliath said to him like this, "Am I a dog that you come to me with sticks?" So David replied to Goliath, "You come to me." David said to the Philistine, "You come to me with a sword, with a spear, and with a javelin," which means Goliath saw that David only had a stick and his slingshot. And he said, he mocked David, saying, "Am I a dog that you come to me, you come to fight with a warrior, you come to fight against a giant, armed to the teeth, and you come with a stick and stones?" So David answered to Goliath, "You come to me with a sword, with a spear, and with a javelin. You are super armed. But I come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied." So, my friend, learn this lesson. Let's learn this lesson. Let's relive this lesson, this story nowadays. Because what has Goliath been to you? What has been your Goliath? This incurable disease? What has been your Goliath? A financial problem? Perhaps your Goliath is the fact that you are unemployed, or your big family that is in misery. Perhaps your Goliath are those that are confronting yours, mine, our faith. It does not matter who the Goliaths are, and it doesn't matter even which weapons they have. It doesn't matter, because the Lord of hosts, when it says Lord of hosts, he wouldn't even have to need an army, a host. He himself, with his word, with the word of his mouth, is already enough to defeat any army, all the powers of darkness, only with his word. But when it says, when it mentions Lord of hosts, is the idea that David had concerning the God of Israel, the Lord of the armies. But we know that when a person believes in the living God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, our Lord Jesus Christ, when a person believes in the Son of God, we believe in God Himself. And this belief involves obedience to His voice, to His word, to His word. And I'm here remembering that a certain time, in a very difficult moment in my life, perhaps the most difficult moment that I faced in life, I was before, I don't even know how many Goliaths. I don't even know how many there were, because there were Goliaths. The first one, the Goliath of religion, the spiritual Goliath from hell, the beast itself. And the other one was the financial problem. And the other one, the other Goliath, was the Goliath of the politics. So I was facing the beast, the political problem, and the financial problem. All three of them at once. And I remember, as if it was yesterday, I remember that I went to the toilet, I placed my face on the floor of the toilet, and I said to God, my Father, everything that I want is to serve you. And if by any chance, that's basically what I said, if by any chance there is any evil intention from my side, any personal desire, then don't listen to me. Just finish it all, end this problem, and may my enemies win. If they have to win, then let them win. However, if you are with me, if you have seen the intentions of my heart, the inclinations of my mind, then help me resolve this problem, because I've done everything that I could do and it didn't work. So now I surrender this in your hands. And I surrendered. I gave Goliath, the Goliath which was the beast from religion. I surrendered the political beast, and I gave as well the financial beast. And I said, now, my God, they are in your hands. I have absolutely nothing to lose. It's yours. if you see fit to give me victory and glorify your name. If not, let your will be done. And amongst the tears, I spoke to God. It's all or nothing. And when I got up from the toilet, I was another person. I got up completely new, as if I had regained all of my strength and started everything all over again. Because there, when I got up with the assurance which is faith. Faith is assurance. The assurance that God had already given me the victory. And this is what happened with David. David, what did he have? He was a weakling. He was a weakling. He was just a boy. He had no conditions to go to war yet. And he was already facing Israel's biggest enemy. But only with one slingshot and a stone, only one stone that represented and represent the stone of faith in the Lord Jesus. Jesus is the cornerstone. Jesus was with that stone in his slingshot. And when he threw that stone, then the giant fell down, and David, from Goliath's own weapon, sword, cut off his head. And God then honored the faith of that young man. God wants to honor your faith, my dear friend. God wants to honor our faith. But now we have to manifest this faith. And faith has nothing to do with feelings. Faith has nothing to do with feelings. God allows us to feel bad and indignant in order for us to take actions, the action of faith, to take that belief in the Word of God and to demand from Him what He has promised. That's all. No more, no less. Do you have faith for that? Then this Sunday, we are going to have the fifth Sunday, because when David got the stones from the river, he got five stones, hand-picked, but he only needed to use one. So tomorrow, Sunday, we are going to have this journey of conquest by faith in the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, the God of David, the God of David, who used one stone to bring down his giant, the giant that everybody was afraid of. So, my friend, when you place your faith in the Word of God, which is the cornerstone, which is the foundation of our faith, the fundament of our faith, then the Word of God will be fulfilled in your life, whether you deserve it or not. It doesn't depend on being deserving. It depends on believing in what He promised. This is and has been the faith of the Universal Church of the Kingdom of God. We know that our enemies use even feces to confront us, but we go against them in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, by the Word of our Lord Jesus Christ, and by the Spirit of our Lord Jesus Christ. What do you think is going to happen? Tell me. What do you think is going to happen? Thank God. May God bless you all, and I'll see you tomorrow in the name of Jesus Christ. Tomorrow, Sunday, the day of the final decision. God bless you all in the name of Jesus. Amen.
UCKG Helpline Call Center is open 24 hours a day, every day of the week, all year round. If you need help due to a serious problem you may be going through, If you feel that you have nowhere to turn to and desperately need someone to lend a listening ear, then we can help you. It doesn't matter who you are or what you have done, your religion or race. Your call will be answered by someone who genuinely cares about you and have your best interests at heart. We also arrange home visits or the housebounds and hospital visits for anyone in great need of kindly human contact. Whether it is simply information you want or desperately need someone to talk to, we're here for you.